evening. What's your name, sir?
My name is Jon Courtenay.
Where are you from?
I live in a village called Mosley, which is near Manchester.
Oh, OK. Have you brought anyone with you?
I've got my wife and two boys, I hear.
Brilliant. How long have you played the piano?
Since I was about five, I guess.
And is that how you make a living?
Yeah.
So is this the biggest venue you've performed in?
Yeah. The Palladium is like the Holy Grail to me. I used to watch the shows with my dad, and this is the home of variety.
Oh.
Overwhelming. It's amazing.
Oh, he's so happy.
Good luck, Jon.
Thank you. This is bonkers.
There was a man who had a dream that Simon Cowell and his team would watch him play piano and try to slay them on the stage of the Palladium. And in the time that one song took, David would write another book. Alicia would smile at him. Amanda would be kind to him. Simon's teeth would be blinding him if he was smiling. But nothing now could ever spoil the dream he dreamed like Susan Boyle.
I like this already. Yes, John.
Let's see if we haven't been in it yet.
Fact is, he never thought he'd ever get to be in front of millions of people doing his thing on TV. 30 years of playing in piano bars and pubs, dodging glasses when they're thrown, being thrown out of clubs. When your children ask, Daddy, when you're coming home, this game is not the same when you're just Daddy on the phone. So he sits at the piano and he tries to get prepared, thinking he'll write it in third person so he doesn't feel as scared to sing about himself to a bunch of strangers in the dark. But then Britain has got talent and he wants to make his mark. Paul Potts won the first year and said it was insane. The second year, George Sampson won, singing in the rain. Lost Voice Guys season 12, and last year, Colin Thackeray. So why not me?
Why not you?
That's what he said. His youngest boy, one night in bed. Dad, why not you? Go and show them what you do. And even though you'll be a wreck, at least you'll meet Anton Dare.
We're in it!
Yeah!
And he thinks on stage, at this stage in his life, with an expensive mortgage and a pensive wife. His youngest son, Alfie, says, what's it all about? If he had any hair left, he'd pull it out. His teenage son said, His dad taught him to play piano, but he didn't live to see his son at the famous theatre performing on TV. If he didn't see it through, imagine how sad the look on the faces of both his lads, who always tell him, you're the greatest showman, Dad. They'll see me on BGT. No more third person, just Daddy. This is me.
You've made me fall to bits, I don't know why. I just saw a man who kind of made all his dreams come true.
It really was, yeah.
David.
It was just so winning, wasn't it? Yeah. I mean, my goodness me, it made the whole audience, and I'm sure everyone watching at home, just fall in love with you.
I love him.
It had everything, and at the end, he had us moved to tears. This show is perfect for you, and now I want to see you go as far as you can in this competition.
Wow.
Well done.
John, it was just a wonderful audition. You're somebody who's worked for years, needs a break. You'll get a huge reaction of this, I promise you. And we all want you to do well. So I would love to be the first to say yes.
I can't believe you did that.
You deserve it. You deserve it. Here's the other son. Here he comes.
Hello. Please introduce yourselves.
So I'm Jade, and what's your name?
Lucas.
Christian. Christian is my little brother, and we're signing along with us.
How old are you?
I'm 18 years old, and how old are you, Christian?
Four.
He's four.
Oh, yeah. My goodness me. Fantastic. What are you going to do for us today?
So we're here to do some sign language and some singing.
Brilliant.
Thank you. We were told that Christian would never be able to communicate. I taught him sign language so then he could talk, and he's here, a little miracle, proving everybody wrong.
Yes, sister! That's what she's supposed to do!
I didn't want to accept that Christian would never be able to communicate. I just knew that there was a voice in there that needed to come out.
Exciting, isn't it?
No.
You're so
cheeky.
We decided we wanted to teach other people this, so we started a class. We're just amazed by how many people wanted to get involved.
I'm Taylor and I'm 7.
I'm Sam, I'm 22.
I'm Ella and I'm 12.
Are you excited to see Sam and Cowell?
Yes.
Yeah.
I'm in love with him anyway.
Ella has actually met Simon before. She won a Child of Courage Award at the Pride of Britain 2019.
You are the sweetest, bravest little girl and you deserve this. Congratulations.
Thank you.
I can't believe I'm on Bitter Talent. It's amazing. It's made my dream come true.
Just got to go out there and show them what we've got, aren't
we? Yeah.
Try our best.
Amazing.
Yes.
We would never normally get an opportunity to do something like this. It's unbelievable. We're just so excited.
We wish you all the best.
Say thank you.
Don't make me melt.
Break me down to dust. I know.
Sensational.
That song is such an anthem for people who maybe don't feel part of the world or part of anything. And I just found it really, really moving.
Thank you.
It was absolutely brilliant.
Hello, thank you.
Welcome.
Thank you.
I genuinely can't find the words.
Amazing!
There you go.
Thank you.
And Christian, you are an absolute little star, so thank you.
Hey, thank you.
I have to confess, I have a friend of mine in this choir. Ella. We met at the Pride of Britain, and I heard Ella sing, and I said, I have a feeling one day you're going to be auditioning on one of our shows, and guess what? You're here. And you're saying, this is me, and I'm thinking, you are us, because you define what this show should be all about. This is an audition I will never, ever forget.
Thank you. I promise you I'll keep
you safe. Every one of you gave everything to this performance, an amazing positive message to put out there, and all I can say is...
Hi, my name is Nabil Abdulrashid, and I'm from Croydon, South London.
Yay! Big up Croydon.
How old are you?
I'm 34.
34. Why are you here today?
I've spent so much time doing other stuff, but now I want to pursue this. It's going to give me a chance to chase my dream and spend more time with my kids.
But you've been harbouring a dream, have you, for the whole
yes.
of your life?
Oh, yes. Or a nightmare, depending on how you look at it. I mean...
Well, look, we don't know what you're going to do. We like to be surprised. So, Nabil, take it away.
So, Sky and all people, you all right? In case you haven't figured it out, yes, I am a stand-up comic. My name is Nabil Abdulrashid, and I am a Muslim, which is something... I'm not going to lie, that's not the reaction I was expecting. I have to announce that I'm Muslim because people never seem to realize I am until it's too late. Recently, like, it was my birthday, right? So my colleagues found out it was my birthday. One of them was like, yo, fam, it's your birthday, can't say nothing, fam, say nothing, fam. Man's got you, fam, man's got a surprise for you, rude man. I said, why are you talking like that? You're Irish. And he said, took me out. Where did he take me? A bar for a cocktail party. I'm like, bruv, you know I don't drink. He said, yeah, yeah, yeah. I know you do the Muslim thing, but it's your birthday, rude boy. Loosen up. It's my birthday, so what next? Hey, Nabil, I know you have a nut allergy, but you see this peanut butter sandwich, fam? It's banging. Loosen up.
It's good, man.
Because people tell me I don't look like a Nabil Abdulrashid. Apparently, I look more like a Tyrone. Or a Marlon, or maybe even a Babatunde, you know, whatever. I turned up to a show recently, they wouldn't let me in. I turned up to the group like, excuse me, you can't be here. This green room is for a Nabil Abdulrashid. I'm like, no, it's Abdulrashid. Yes, that's what I said, Abdulrashid. My mother said, I don't mean to offend you, but has anyone ever told you that your name sounds a bit Muslim. I said, yes, that's because I am a Muslim. He said, okay, well, at least tell me what the name means. I said, the name Nabil Abdulrashid basically means that my phone calls are monitored. Now... The annoying thing about being Muslim in 21st century Britain is you know the MI5 prevent and Home Office listening on your phone calls, but they don't go halves on the bill. They follow you on Twitter, they don't retweet. They follow you on Facebook, but they don't poke. Well, not on Facebook, they poke you at the airport. I mean.
That's my time, man. Right.
It was fantastic.
The writing is perfect, the delivery is perfect. I want to say thank you for coming on this show and bringing this style of humour, because it makes the show grow.
I didn't think I was going to do that today, but it just felt right. You are a breath of fresh air.
Give your...
God, this isn't going to be a scary thing, is it?
What's going on?
Thank you.
was terrifying.
That was incredible.
Really good.
Well, underneath this cloth is something really special. And we're going to get back to it in a bit. Now, because I'm a magician, my children have grown up watching magic almost every single day of their lives. About a year ago, my little boy Dylan told me that he wants to become a magician too. And when I told him I was auditioning for Britain's Got Talent, he came up with an amazing idea. And I'd like to share that with you today. Dylan has given me a list of different things that he would like for his birthday. It contains 56 different items. Simon, would you call out a number from 1 to 56?
25.
25. Where are my notes? Right there. You can see that I have one list. It's Dylan's birthday list.
Yep.
And it contains 56 different items.
Yep.
Would you please remember what's at number 25? Don't say what it is.
I've got it.
And we'll get back to it in a bit.
Yeah.
Now, most children get bedtime stories before they go to sleep. I used to show mine card tricks. And you can see that all of these cards are different. Would you please touch the back of anyone? This one?
Yeah.
Now, it's okay if we all see what it is. It is the Five of Hearts. Simon, would you please think of someone who's really special in your life? And would you print their name in big letters? It's okay if I see. Eric, this is your little boy, right?
Yeah.
Cool, okay. Would you please hold your hand out for me? And would you please put your other hand on top? Now, I want you all to watch this really closely, because something extraordinary is about to happen. It's gone. Take a look. Simon's card has completely disappeared.
Wow. Simon! Simon! It's in here.
No.
My name is Dylan Piper, and that's my dad. Before we came here tonight, he gave me his wallet. And inside this wallet is something impossible.
Simon, this wallet was inside Dylan's pocket before you picked your card. And that's what makes this so impossible. Because inside this wallet, there is another wallet. And inside this wallet, there is a zip. Now, the only way in is if I undo this zip.
Yep.
And inside is a folded up playing card. Take a look and show everyone.
No way.
Oh my God.
That is so good.
Simon, it's fair to say that you could have had any card.
Yeah.
But you picked the Five of Hearts.
Yes.
We knew this from the very beginning. And to prove it, I brought along my twin brother, Joseph.
What? What's that? Because it's just getting better and better.
The relationship between a father and a son is a truly magical one.
Simon, you know this, being a father yourself. Your little boy is called Eric.
Simon and Eric.
You chose a random item from my birthday list.
Yes, I did.
Would you please tell everyone what it is?
It was number 25 and it was a jet ski.
A jet ski?
Simon and Eric riding a jet ski.
Amazing, what a finish!
What?
What's your name?
Fayth.
Fayth, how old are you?
12 years old.
Wow. And where are you from?
I'm from Swindon.
Are you feeling nervous?
No.
Nervous and excited.
What did you think when you woke up this morning?
I was like, oh my days. Is this even real? I started pinching myself. Oh, this isn't real. I can't be doing this yet.
Aww.
What a great personality. Can I ask you a question? Have you ever had moments when you've lost your confidence? I'm really curious.
I have lost my confidence a little bit with, like, a bit of negative energy from different schools, from,
yeah.
like, because... But my mum and my dad, they helped me get through that, which is why I'm here today. So...
OK, my darling. Well, good luck. This is your moment.
Thank you.
She's so cute.
I mean, just occasionally, and it is very occasionally on this show, someone comes onto the stage, you think they are born to be a superstar.
Thank you.
You know what I love about you, Fayth, is that I absolutely love your personality.
Thank you.
And you talked about the support you had from your mum and dad. Then you see the support you've had from 3,000 people, and just to give you a little bit more support, I'm going to give you one of those. Oh,
why Tina Turner's just come back. Remember what I said? With you, you could sing the phone book.
My heart is beating.
Enjoy every moment.
Hey, Daddy.
Hello, Dad. Hey, well done.
Hey. Amazing.
Thank you very much.
That was such an amazing audition.
That's amazing.
Thank you so much, Simon.
It was an absolute pleasure. Brilliant. I asked the question if you've ever had any negativity, because when I grew up, I had that as well. And the most important thing is they never get to you. And when you're as good as you are, you win. You know, it kind of gives you that strength and determination. So if anyone ever says anything negative, remember this moment. Okay?
Oh, my God, that's so amazing. Thank you so much, Simon.
It's an absolute pleasure to meet you both.
Thank you.
You will stop.
Come here, well done.